We'll talk some sports right now with our guy, Danan Hughes, former Chiefs wide receiver. He, of course, is part of the Chiefs radio network. He'll be out in L.A. this weekend on the call with Mitch Holthus, Dan Israel, Josh Klingler. You also hear him for Players Only this evening on 610 Sports Radio. What's going on, Danan? Happy New Year, man.
Happy New Year, fellas. Everything's good. Had a blessed and safe and happy holiday, so I'm all good. The Chiefs got the W, so that makes it even better. We can kind of ease off the gas pedal this week, go out to sunny California, and try to end the season on a high note and get ready for the playoffs. So yeah, everything's good in my world.
Absolutely. Well, good to hear, man. What's the player mindset though when you do enter a week like this where there's going to be numerous starters, as we know, not playing? We already know Patrick Mahomes is not going to play. Blaine Gabbert's going to start. What does that do for a mindset of a team during practice and even heading into this game as a whole?
Well, it depends. Depends which player you're talking about. Which players are you specifically talking about? Maybe positions or players, and I'll tell you the different mindsets. Because I think from a starter's perspective or a star perspective, their mindset is definitely different than the number three, number four, number five receivers / DBs and other depth guys.
When you look at what they're going to do with Travis Kelce,
go ahead. Yeah, no, I was gonna, so yeah, I mean, if you are a player like Travis Kelce, where you know you're 16 yards away from 1,000 yards, you know he's going to have some conversation with Andy this week. How do you think that plays out?
Well, I think first, if the decision is made that he's going to play, actually just not go through pregame warm-ups and sit on the sideline. Fortunately for these guys, it'll be in a warm weather place, so sitting out on the sideline is not going to be, anything that's going to be a headache to them. Having the discussion with Andy about whether he's going to play. Now, once that decision is made, then they both know the reason why he's playing is to get that 16 yards. And knowing an offensive-minded coach, you're scripting plays before the game, got to guarantee if there's any other tell to the Chargers, it's going to be that if 87 is on the field, he's likely going to get the ball and quickly. So if we haven't been predictable in any other game, I'd say the beginning of the Chargers game, we'd be very predictable. But for Travis, I feel like that's a milestone to be able to put yourself in a position to have that kind of streak and keep it sustained. Is a testament to his durability and his production. Now, if you're looking at guys like Joshua Williams or Jalen Watson or Felix, they're going to approach the game differently. Like, this is their opportunity to shine like it's the third preseason game. And you approach it the same way. So hopefully none of those guys, because they get 20, 30 plays in a regular game, feel like they're too big for this fourth preseason game. Like, this is still your opportunity to showcase on film that you are a viable threat or a viable asset to this team or any other team. And that's how you have to look at it. You know, as a guy that was that third, fourth, fifth receiver throughout my career, like, I seized every opportunity to be on the field. It didn't matter preseason or regular season or postseason. And most of the guys outside of Travis, Chris, obviously Patrick, maybe a couple of the offensive linemen, probably are approaching this game the same way.
Based on like what Blaine Gabbert said yesterday, we don't think it's going to go down like this, but we spent a lot of time talking about hand to handle the wide receivers, right? Like, hey, do you bench somebody for a week to like put him in a place? Alex's idea for MVS was play him. Give him 70 snaps and throw him the ball 15 times just to like get him out of the funk. Would that work? Or does MVS just feel like, hey, I'm not getting the veteran treatment versus these other guys if you're just going to throw me in there and make me work through my problems?
I think it depends on the makeup of the player. Like, again, it kind of goes back to that previous comment where if you think that you're above this opportunity, then you're not going to treat it as the professional that everybody expects you to be. And maybe the expectations that the coaches want from you. So if there is a coach, if Connor Embry, Matt Nagy, and Andy Reid come together and say, you know what, MVS needs to play about 40 snaps. There's normal amount of snaps, and let's let's put together a game plan around getting him the ball more than we normally would. He's got to embrace that as a pro, because I can tell you that if he's not embracing that, that's going to speak more to his makeup and his viability to be in the NFL, not just this team, but in the NFL in the future, than any drops that he may have in the game. Because as you get to a threshold where you are a blue-collar player, then you're a starter, then you're a number one or number two starter viable threat. Then when you get to that veteran area where maybe some of the holes in your game have been displayed when you were a starter, you become the guy that can be an asset to a team in the locker room, on the practice field, developing other receivers, and still maybe being a number three/four receiver. You cut that whole level out if you don't approach these type of games in the right way. So I hope that he would approach it professionally, but if he doesn't, like, you may not see a whole bunch more of MVS in the NFL.
Part of my problem, Danan, is I'm not so sure MVS would handle it that way. If the Chiefs are who they are, but like, he might be the only player on the team that I don't recall a moment, Danan, in which he took accountability the way the other players have. Like, I don't feel like he's just stood up there and been like, yeah, my bad. Like, it even seemed like we were critical of him after the game, where it seemed like he showed up pat on the field a little bit after a ball that was in his hands was dropped. I'm not sure MVS would take it that way.
That's a big question. And I think that's where coaching comes in. The relationship you have with your coaches is different than it was in college and high school. Like, we're on first name basis. We're both men. We both have families. We're both doing this as our profession. Evidently, we are both, as coach and player, the best that is presented in this business. That's why you are the position coach here, because there's only 31 other of your position. And hopefully he has that kind of relationship with his coaches that they feel comfortable. And sometimes it might not be your position coach. It could be a different coach. It could be a scout, someone in player personnel that comes to you and is like, hey, man, like, I'm not into the X's and O's. I'm not into what you've gone through these 16 games. But here's what I can tell you from an outsider looking in, or here's what I can tell you from the front offices, or et cetera. You can embrace it, or you can have an attitude and think you're above it. It's your choice. The ball is in your hands. So that's where I think the relationship in the building comes into play in that circumstance. And it might be drastically different than what we've seen up to this point, because we all know, I was surprised when I got cut. Most guys are surprised when they get released or when their careers are over. You'd like to think that if a circumstance presents itself where a guy has a reality check and can be jolted into a positive framework, that they would embrace it, but who knows?
We're talking to Danan Hughes here on Cody and Gold. Okay, so Sunday, look, the Chiefs are locked into a 3-seed already, so we can look ahead a little bit. When you look at the potential opponents that the Chiefs could face, whether it's Miami, Buffalo, and there's scenarios where it could be Pittsburgh or Indy or Houston, who are you preferring comes to Arrowhead next weekend?
I'd say the latter three, not because I'm scared of the abilities of the Bills and the Dolphins. I just am always leery. And you could have asked me this question the last 5 years, the last 10 years, last 20 years. And anytime you played a team during the regular season and then have to play them in the playoffs again, I just get leery. My stomach turns a little bit, because I feel like if you beat them, then they may have a little bit of an edge in coming in that second time around, especially if they're healthy. If you've lost to them, then there's a confidence that they had, especially a team like the Bills that has come into Arrowhead Stadium for, you know, multiple years, and their season has either ended or they've had wins in the regular season. I just don't like that matchup as much as a new team that is, of those three teams, pretty much grinded their way into the playoffs to come into Arrowhead Stadium against Patrick Mahomes, not having faced him this year, and trying to seek out a win in a playoff game. I feel more comfortable with those latter three teams than the two teams we played this year.
Dana, what about the notion that is like it is hard to maintain that level forever? Essentially, the Bills have been playing playoff football for 2 months. Like, they've been fighting for their life for like 8 straight weeks. At some point, don't you run out on that back end?
I don't think that's automatic. I think it's the makeup of the team, and that team is more veteran-laden team, if I remember correctly, from their depth chart when we played them during the season. And they've been through those storms, and those storms happen to happen here for the most part. So I feel like, you know, based on how they were acting with 13 seconds left and on the sideline, the celebrations, the taunting to the fans, coming back here and wanting to do everything to avoid that feeling again, it doesn't matter what they experienced over the last 6, 7, 8 weeks getting to that point. So that can be scary. But if you get ahead of them early and you're able to keep your foot on the gas pedal, then that type of team, because they've been drained for several weeks, they might roll over.
Danan Hughes, former Chiefs wide receiver, he joins us every single Thursday. What do you got planned tonight, players only?
We're going to be back in the building. It seems like it's been kind of hit and miss for us and players only. I think Barbershop will be in there with me, but I'm not sure yet. We're going to have some fun. So much to cover in an hour, so that's going to make it a little bit challenging, but we always have fun. So ready to take this game onto the into the booth for the playoff run. So, yeah, we'll have a good time.
There you go. We'll be listening tonight. Thanks, Danan.
All right, guys.